In this video, we will discuss the problems of Lagrange's PDE by using method of grouping. Consider the problem: solve P tan x plus Q tan y equal to tan j. Consider P into tan x given, Q into tan y equal to tan z. This is taken as equation 1. Now we check whether this is linear or non-linear. The given PDE contains P, the power of P is 1, and the power of P is also 1. And the second condition, the given PDE does not contain P and Q in the same term. Thus, it is a linear PDE. Since it is a linear PDE, we compare the given PDE with Lagrange's linear equation, capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q equal to capital R. By comparing with this, here the quotient of small p is capital P, here the quotient of small p is equal to tan x. Hence we have write P equal to tan x. By comparing the quotient of small q, here the quotient of small q is capital Q, here the quotient of small q is tan y. So we take capital Q equal to tan y. By comparing RHS on both sides, we have capital R equal to tan z. This is step 1. This is step 1. After finding P, Q, R, we write the auxiliary equations. What are the auxiliary equations? Dx by capital P equal to dy by capital Q equal to dz by capital R. Now we substitute the values of P, Q, R in this auxiliary equations. Then we get dx by tan x equal to dy by tan y equal to dz by tan z. From this we consider any two fractions. First we consider the first and second fraction. For grouping, first we check it is possible to group dx by tan x equal dy by tan y. Yes, we can directly solve dx by tan x equal to dy by tan y. Why? Because when you consider dx by tan x dy by tan y, the denominators may contain x comma y and does not contain z. Here the denominators tan x tan y does not contain any z, so we can group. That means we can find the solution from these two fractions. Now we can take integral on both sides. Then we have 1 by tan x is nothing but cot x into dx. Integral of 1 by tan y is nothing but cot y into dy plus c. Integral of cot x is nothing but log mod sin x. Integral of cot y is nothing but log mod sin y. Since the two integrals have logarithmic function, in place of arbitrary constant, we also take logarithmic value for the simplification. Now we write log sin y to the left hand side. Then we have log sin x minus log sin y equal to log c1. Log a minus log b is nothing but log of a by b. Log of sin x by sin y equal to log c1. By canceling log on both sides, we have sin x by sin y equal to c1. This is the one solution. Now we find the another solution. To find the second solution, we consider second and third fractions. Here the second fraction is dy by tan y equal to third fraction dz by tan z. So we take dy by tan y equal to dz by tan z. So now we check whether we can find the solution directly from these two fractions. If the numerators contains dy dz, then the denominators may contain y comma z and does not contain x. clearly the denominator tan y tan z does not contain any x. So we can directly solve this. Now we take integrals on both sides. Then integral of 1 by tan y is nothing but cot y dy equal to integral of 1 by tan z is nothing but cot z into dz. Integral of cot y is nothing but log sin y. Integral of cot z is nothing but log mod sin z plus, in place of arbitrary constants, we take log c2. We write this to the left hand side. Log of sin y minus log of sin z equal to log c2. Log a minus log b equal log of a by b. Sin y by sin z equal to log c2. By cancelling log on both sides, we get sin y by sin z equal to c2. After finding the two linearly independent solutions, we write the general solution is pi of c1 comma c2 equal to 0. That means pi of c1 is nothing but sin x by sin y. C2 is nothing but sin y by sin z equal to 0, where pi is an arbitrary function. Now we consider the second problem, solve z into z square plus xy into px minus py equal to x power 4. We consider the given DE. When we multiply the px py with z into z square plus xy, we get this. This is taken as equation 1. Now we observe whether equation 1 is linear or not. Here the power of p is 1 and power of q is 1. And the given PDE does not contain p and q together in the same term, since it is a linear. Now we compare the, according to the working rule, now we compare the given equation with the Lagrange's linear equation, capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q equal to r. By comparing the quotient of small p in these two equations, we have capital P equal to xz into z square plus xy. By comparing the quotients of capital Q, here the quotient of capital, by comparing the quotient of small q, here the quotient of small q is capital Q, that means capital Q equal to the quotient of small q equal to minus yz into z square plus xy. By comparing RHS on both sides, we have R equal to x power 4. This is step 1. In step 2, we consider the auxiliary equations. Dx by capital P equal to dy by capital Q equal to dz by capital R. Now we substitute the values of capital P, capital Q, capital R in this formula. Then we get the subsidiary equations. To find the solution, first we consider the first and second ratios. Dx by xz into z square plus xy equal dy by minus z into z square plus xy. If the numerators contains dx dy, then the denominators contains x comma y and does not contain z. But here in the given problem, here the denominator of dx contains z terms and dy of denominator of dy also contains the z terms. But we can remove the z by cancelling out from the denominators. By cancelling out this, then we get 1 by x dx equal to minus 1 by y dy. So we can find the solution from this. So we take integrals on both sides. Integral of 1 by x dx minus integral of 1 by y dy. Integral of 1 by x equal to log x. Integral of 1 by y equal to log y plus log c1. Then log x plus log y equal to log c1. Log of xy equal to log c1. By cancelling log, we get xy equal to c1. That means we get one solution. By considering first and second ratios, we can one solution. So if you suppose consider the second and third fractions. If you consider second and third fractions, then in the numerator of second fraction it contains y. In the numerator of third fraction it contains z. That means the denominators may contain y, z and does not contain x. But here the denominators contains x. But we cannot eliminate x from these two denominators. That means if we consider the second and third fraction, we cannot find the solution directly. So there is no use if we consider second and third fractions. Now the remaining possibility is the first and third fractions. If we consider the first and third ratios, then in the first ratio, we have dx, and in the second ratio we have dz. That means the denominators must contain x comma z, may contain x comma z and does not contain y. So from this, here there is only y appears only in this term. So we can remove this xy by using the first solution. That means now we cancel x on both sides, then we get x on both sides, then we get x cube by cross multiplying x cube dx equal to z into z square plus xy into dz. So in case of dx dz, there is no y appears in this integrands. So to remove y from this, we use the first solution, xy equal to c1. Now we substitute xy equal to c1 here. Then we get x cube dx equal z into z square plus c1 dz. So by using variable separable method, the terms of x are taken towards dx, the terms of z are taken towards dz. There is no y. Hence we take integrals on both sides. Integral of x cube is x power 4 by 4, z cube is z power 4 by 4, integral of z is z square by 2, we get plus c2. Now we substitute c1 equal to xy. So we get c2. After finding two linearly independent solutions, we write the general solution, pi of c1 comma c2 equal to 0, where pi is an arbitrary function. That means in this problem, we find the first solution directly by grouping, but in to find the second solution, it is not possible to eliminate y from these two fractions. So for that, we eliminate y by using the solution of the first linearly independent solution. After that, we find the second solution.